Monster Raw. Everyone wants to watch their WWF, and you can get that shot, as we just saw, this coming Tuesday night. Your choice is either, once again, the encore of the Royal Rumble or Bill Clinton's State of the Union. Take your pick.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Attention Sega CD fans! Unleash the rage in the cage with 20 supercharged WWF superstars in incredible steel cage action from Acclaim.
Who knows, there could be some crash dummies in next year's WWF Royal Rumble matchup. Look at this, Diesel takes the step over the top rope. Not too many people can do that. And Tyrone now locking up with Shawn Michaels.
Diesel stock really rose in my eyes after the Royal Rumble match itself this past Saturday night, Vince. But I'll tell you something, if he watches the encore tomorrow night, he may part the way with his pal, Shawn Michaels.
Indeed, it was Diesel who challenged Michaels when he first came in the ring. And remember now, it was every man for himself, and that's a thing you only see once a year in the WWF. Look at Michaels, he is arrogant. Well, although he wasn't as arrogant as you thought he might be when Diesel invited him to go one-on-one. He declined that opportunity. And then from there, Michaels one of the individuals who shoved Diesel over the top with everyone else in the ring?
I thought he just stood back and watched. He didn't try to help his bodyguard or associate or whatever the heck he is.
Actually, I think the encore will show that Michaels was the last man in, just an extra little touch added to the 8 or 10 people in there who actually threw Diesel over the top. And you're right, if Diesel sees that footage, I don't think he's gonna be hanging around Shawn Michaels. Michaels, oh, look at this! Michaels missing! Tyrone coming out of the corner, Tyrone working on the same left arm and shoulder. Tyrone Knox winding up Shawn Michaels. And everyone saw, if you saw, last Saturday night, look at the look of intensity in the eyes of Diesel. Could you believe what Shawn Michaels did to Razor Ramon, Jeff?
Well, he almost pulled it off. He almost succeeded in doing exactly what we know he wanted to do, and that was to make sure that Razor Ramon did not leave Providence, Rhode Island with the Intercontinental belt.
Yes, indeed. And there for a while, everyone thought, including the official, that Irwin R. Scheister, who obviously has a bone to pick later on with the officiating, IRS thought for sure he was the new Intercontinental Champion, thanks to Shawn Michaels. But then, thank goodness, better officiating prevailed. The match allowed to continue, and I'm not too sure IRS even, take a look at this.
That's the right hand.
Nah, he's not gonna bother with it. Tyrone back in there. Tyrone Knox and Shawn Michaels. Michaels, one of the more aggressive and certainly one of the more arrogant individuals in all the WWF.
He certainly says he's the wrestler of the 90s. I think Mr. Machismo has something to say about that. And I can't wait when those two will finally get together and settle this whole Intercontinental title situation. Great dropkick there, once and for all.
Razor Ramon, unquestionably looking forward to the opportunity, especially considering the happenings at the Royal Rumble matchup last Saturday. Razor looking forward to once again facing Shawn Michaels. By the way, did you watch any football this past weekend, Jim?
Every down of every game.
Uh-huh.
Big Cowboy fan, you know.
Unfortunately for CBS, as everyone knows, losing the NFL package, going over to the Fox Network. I'd like to, however, put to rest the rumor that Neil Pilson, president of CBS Sports, has been negotiating with the World Wrestling Federation to bring the WWF to CBS to replace the NFL package. That is not true. The World Wrestling Federation is staying right here on USA, America's favorite cable network, and America's favorite show, no doubt, Monday Night Raw. To the Bucko right now, and Tyrone Knox is taking his Knox. And again, but no, how about that?
Tyrone must have a pretty hard head.
Tyrone, no headbutt.
You go, Tyrone.
And reversal there, Tyrone coming up. Uh-oh, that wasn't on the forehead, that was underneath the chin.
So much for momentum for old Tyrone there.
Who does this man remind you of? Former television star Shawn Michaels reminds you of who? Eddie Haskell.
Yeah, I think so. He's a condescending, arrogant young man. Yeah, Leave It to Beaver's Eddie Haskell. I think it fits him to a T. Boy,
driver. That would have fitted Tyrone to a T.
Yeah, flattened out his head.
We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, with our Monday Night Raw. Stay with us. are back with more World Wrestling Federation action. And let's go to ringside.
Johnson.
LaToya Jackson. I just saw her.
That's LaTanya Johnson. Oh, not LaToya Jackson. Uh-oh.
Look at LaToya going to get run over.
Yeah. Woo! Here comes one of those big old 16-wheelers, or ever how many wheels you have on that big monster.
Saluting for one fall, instantly first wrestling. First weighing 317 pounds.
What's the word?
Go ahead, LaTanya. Go ahead. Johnson hooked on phonics. And she'll be back for more ring announcing. Diesel is awesome. This matchup ready to get underway. Who's gonna win? We don't know. Anything can happen in the WWF.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
All right, here we go. We are back, and we are ready for action. Tommy Angel squaring off against this huge monster, Diesel.
I know Tommy Angel. He's from Charlotte, North Carolina. I've been out with the guy several times, but I tell you what, he's up against a mammoth of a man right there in Diesel.
Yes, indeed. Diesel now reversing thing. Angel coming off the rope. Roundhouse misses. Angel coming back, and look at that.
Oh, my goodness.
Ah, look, this is unbelievable that a man like Diesel can just manhandle Angel.
He can manhandle anybody.
And you can bet that Shawn Michaels knows that Diesel can manhandle most anyone. Look at this. Diesel coming up and down across the throat.
Ah, like a runaway 18-wheeler.
Diesel having some fun in there. You can bet Angel's having no fun at all. With a chin lock applied by Diesel. He knows what he's doing in there.
Look at the leverage. Look at that. His neck's been all the way over.
Massive being, this Diesel. And you know what is really astonishing?
What's that?
See the likes of him. Let's just stay with this action here. Angel coming up.
Oh, size 17, right in the face.
Everyone knows Shawn Michaels is arrogant, to say the least. But you haven't seen arrogance until you see Shawn Michaels in the presence of Diesel. Outside of the building or inside. Oh, look at that!
Well, Shawn Michaels very simply knows anything he can handle, Diesel can.
Yes. Knows it very
quickly. Look at here.
And an easy three count.
It's done.
From the mammoth Diesel. We're talking Diesel power here in the World Wrestling Federation. Mackie Hill raise his own hand in victory, or maybe Shawn Michaels will. Look at this.
Oh!
How about that? Michaels is as big as Diesel. Yeah, as if he didn't know he was standing on top of poor Angel. What's this? We're told now, ladies and gentlemen, that standing by, we're going to have with us the Quebecers, Jacques, and his tag team partner, Pierre, the tag team champions of the WWF momentarily. Diesel very impressive here this week, as he was at the WWF Royal Rumble matchup. I would suggest we're likely to see Diesel in WrestleMania 10.
WWF superstars, more with the dapper duo of Vince McMahon and Stan Lane in just a moment or two. Great program for you right here next week as well. Vince and Stan will tell you about that before we go off the air. You know, ladies and gentlemen, if you're listening to Radio WWF, we thank you. If you're not, you don't know what you're missing. I hope you'll call your local radio station, let them know about Radio WWF. We're on every Saturday night from 9 until 11 Eastern time, and we take your telephone calls and have the biggest guests from the WWF on each and every week. You know, an interesting thing I thought at this past Saturday at the WWF Royal Rumble was the Intercontinental Championship matchup involving the champion, Razor Ramon and IRS. I predicted that IRS would win the Intercontinental Championship. I was wrong. Razor Ramon is to be commended for overcoming not only the great physical challenges of Irwin R. Scheister, but also Shawn Michaels' situation at ringside as well. I did catch up to Irwin. He still is very focused. You know, he's Rush Limbaugh's favorite athlete here in the WWF, and I asked good old Irwin what his goals were for 1994.
First of all, I have several goals.
but I'll tell you the one that's number one on my list. That's you, Razor Ramon. Because at Royal Rumble, if it wasn't for bad officiating and your cheating ability, I would be standing here right now, Razor Ramon, as the Intercontinental Champion. But obviously I'm not. But I'm not one to cry about spilled milk, Razor Ramon, because I know deep down in my mind, I'm more intelligent, I'm a better wrestler, and I'm much better looking than you. So that leads me to 1994. And like I said, the goal is to become the Intercontinental Champion. And sooner or later, Ramon, everybody pays IRS.
He's a strong conservative, folks. Rush Limbaugh's favorite wrestler, and contrary to popular belief, I don't look like Rush Limbaugh. Well, maybe a little. But anyway, I talked to Razor Ramon, and I asked Razor what was going through his mind, almost losing the Intercontinental title the way he did to Irwin.
I gotta admit, no surprises at the Rumble for Razor Ramon. I knew going in, the Taxman is tough. He lived up to his billing. I also knew that the boy toy is going crazy because Razor Ramon has a gold belt too. I feel great because I got what everybody wants. That means I must be a pretty big deal here in the WWF. Anybody else wants some? I'm easy to find. Just look for the guy oozing machismo.
Well, the bad guy is a marked man, but he's ready for any challenge, whether it be from Irwin R. Scheister or Shawn Michaels or whomever, and we'll get you back to action momentarily.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen.
Get back to your position.
Irwin R. Scheister.
We had enough. Get back to your position. Let's go.
Irwin R. Scheister is looking everywhere. He has been looking everywhere for his briefcase during the entire... I have no idea where your briefcase...
You don't have any idea. You're sitting right here.
Well, I was sitting right there when you knocked me over just about. Yeah.
You didn't take my briefcase.
Irwin R. Scheister, I guess, on his way back to the dressing room to find Marty Jannetty. He thinks Marty Jannetty stole his briefcase.
Come on,
let's stay with him if we can. Let's follow Irwin all the way back. IRS is on quick. Wait a minute, what's that? Whoa, wait just a moment. Hey, look at that. Look what's around Razor's neck. Can you believe that? Look what is around. Gold. Yes, the kid apparently opened the briefcase and found the gold. It's now worn. Look at it by Razor Ramon. And I believe Irwin has his briefcase back, but it might be a little bit lighter than it was before. Irwin, not a happy camper. Stay with.
All right, back out here, ladies and gentlemen, with Irwin R. Scheister, and standing by, I believe, do we have Razor Ramon? There we go, Marty Jannetty, Razor Ramon. Look at the gold. It never looked better than it does right now around your race. Razor Ramon.
But how real about funny, McMahon. But there's a couple of thieves if I've ever seen one.
Hey, wait a minute. What about the matchup next week? Marty, you one-on-one with Razor Ramon.
You know, I want to say something, McMahon.
I beg your pardon.
And Taxman. Oye, me chico, you talking about you want Marty Jannetty? You got him.
Here I am. You know, isn't it typical of the IRS to kick a man while he's down? Take advantage of an unfair situation. The 1-2-3 kid sitting there with his leg in a cast, and you want to jump on him? Well, let me tell you something, IRS. For every man that's been abused by the IRS, you're going to get satisfaction and inform of Marty Jannetty kicking your butt. I'll tell you right now, you won't whoop me without the help of your stinking government. And you can take that to the bank and then steal it from yourself.
Thank you very much. Marty Jannetty, ladies and gentlemen, looking forward to the match.
I surely am.
We'll be right back.
But you're going to pay, Jannetty.
All right, we are kicking things off here this week with the squared circle, a most controversial athlete, Stan.
You know, you got that right, and there he is once again with that Intercontinental belt. It's not recognized by the World Wrestling Federation, but that is the original belt.
Yes, he never gave it up. Jack Tunney, president of the World Wrestling Federation, stripped Shawn Michaels of the title, as perhaps he should have. Nonetheless, Michaels never actually relinquished the original Intercontinental Championship belt. However, the Intercontinental Championship title is recognized and won by the one and the only,
the bad guy,
Razor Ramon. And Razor Ramon is the undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
And I dare say, if it wasn't for that 7-foot-plus Diesel, Shawn Michaels would have maybe given up that belt a long time ago.
Along with maybe a whole lot more. Look at Michaels going through those gyrations. Give me a break. Shawn Michaels, truly one of a kind, most controversial. Taking a look at himself in the reflection of the... But there you see, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at the WWF magazine. Take a look at The Undertaker. And on the inside, you can take another look at Shawn Michaels, who, well, he's claiming that you can just call him champ.
Indeed.
Diesel behind Shawn Michaels. And Michaels many times accompanying Diesel to the squared circle, as we saw last week. Diesel, an unbelievable force to reckon with here. An awesome superpower in the World Wrestling Federation.
To one of the few athletes who can step over the top rope with no problem.
Shawn Michaels, look at this. Sabah, arm drag takedown, nicely done. Sabah again. Sabah, an experienced athlete, knows exactly what he's doing in there. And maybe Shawn Michaels has bitten off more than they can chew this week. Maybe it's right here that Shawn Michaels is embarrassed.
Well, I don't know if he'd be embarrassed, Vince, but this scary Sabah, who hails from Italy, he must have some pretty good mat wrestling skills over there. And
oh, I don't know that he hails from Italy. I think that's just where his tights are made from.
Oh, I see.
Sabah working on the left arm and shoulder. And Shawn Michaels, a thinking man's type wrestler, if you would. Always thinking of counters and always think, oh, my goodness, that man's thinking something. Thinking destruction. And a tackle there, Sabah. Off the rope, coming right in front. Oh, Michaels with a drop kick, nailing him. Yeah, Michaels.
Shaking the finger.
Yeah, right. Big slam there by Shawn Michaels. And see the way Michaels, again, in the presence of Diesel, Michaels just getting right in the face, literally, of Gary Sabah. He won't do that if Diesel isn't around.
It's called major backup on hand, if needed.
Shawn Michaels and Gary Sabah starting things off this week. Sabah for the ride. Here comes Michaels. Oh. In a forearm, flying forearm of sorts. Legal maneuver for a change on that occasion there, ref. By the way, a little bit later on, as was outlined, 1-2-3 kid, Marty Jannetty. In tag team action. Sabah taking it to Michaels now. Sabah with a chop. Michaels ducking out of the way. And oh, on the side of the head, the super kick, and Michaels in complete control. Sabah is down. He's down for the count. And another victory for the master of chewing gum. And Shawn Michaels with another victory here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Bam! A lot of force on that power slam.
Marty Jannetty with IRS now trying to set him up again.
IRS being whipped from one side to the other. Oh, yes! Into the chest. Marty Jannetty with a survive. What is this? Johnny Polo coming to ringside. Polo, the manager of the Quebecers. He has no business down there as well.
What's he got in his hand? A mop panel, McMahon? What is that?
That's a cue stick.
A cue stick? I thought that hair and that mop panel might go together.
And down goes Irwin. Marty Jannetty, cover him, shoot the half, go. Come on. 1, 2, 3. No.
No, not 3, McMahon.
Oh, wait a minute.
What's he out here snooping around for now?
Well, wait a minute. You got Johnny Polo in one corner. The Razor coming down to take a look in the other. And I believe we're going to have a victory for Marty Jannetty.
I think you're counting your chickens before their hatch, man. I don't know what Ramon thinks he's doing
yes.
Out there.
A clothesline, a cover, not a gun. Oh, so close.
I still don't know what Ramon's doing.
Wait a minute. Red Shock and Beer, they're back. What's going on here? Jannetty coming up underneath. Jannetty now on top of IRS, going for the sleeper hold. Marty Jannetty trying to apply the sleeper hold.
Oh, wait a minute, they're circling Razor. The Quebecers coming closer and closer to Razor Ramon on the outside of the ring. Marty Jannetty coming closer and closer to victory on the inside. Right in front of Johnny Polo. Marty Jannetty back on his feet, trying to set up IRS. And, oh, look at that. Polo interfered with the momentum of Jannetty. A cover by IRS. And, oh, no. Give me a break. Wait a minute. Razor Ramon just jumped it in the ring. Hello, IRS. Razor Ramon with Irwin. Look out from behind. Shock and Pierre attacking Razor Ramon.
Trying to drive him down to the canvas. Look at this. Razor back up on his feet.
Razor Ramon against two men. From behind, Marty Jannetty's back on his feet as well. Four men going at it. Razor has the gold back around his neck. The gold around his waist. Jannetty setting up Pierre. Oh, my. And a roundhouse right by the bad guy. Razor Ramon, look at this. Over goes Pierre. Shock is left in the ring. Off the rope. Double boots to the midsection.
Uh-oh.
The Razor's Edge is coming to Quebec. The Razor's Edge coming to Jacques the Quebecer. There is no escape now. Down to the canvas. And now, Pierre is pulling Jacques out of the ring. Johnny Polo to help out as well. But unfortunately, this one will go down in the record book as a victory for Irwin R. Scheister.
I'll tell you something, man. I want some hot dogs out here. It's exciting. I'm so excited. I forgot to eat. Get some hot dogs, mustard, ketchup, pickles, everything. Bring it all out here.
We'll be back with more Monday Night Raw.
Back. Plus, in a match just announced, Razor Ramon defends against Shawn Michaels. If that isn't enough, this is a ladder match. Yeah, you heard me right, a ladder match. Let me explain. The Intercontinental belt is on the line with a huge ladder in the middle of the ring. Suspended above is not only Razor's Intercontinental Championship belt, but Shawn's bogus belt as well. Now, the first man who climbs the ladder, gets the belts, is the winner and the Intercontinental Champion. And get this, the ladder is in play. You baseball fans understand that. Can you imagine the havoc a steel ladder could cause in the middle of the ring? Let's find out how these two participants feel about this very unusual matchup.
A historical event, WrestleMania 10, Madison Square Garden, Sunday afternoon, March 20th, with an unprecedented match. And who better to give it to you than the main man himself, the Heartbreak Kid, the axis in which the World Wrestling Federation revolves around, Shawn Michaels, a ladder match, two belts hanging at the top of Madison Square Garden, along with all those people hanging from the rafters. The Heartbreak Kid is gonna be up there taking what is rightfully his, the IC belt.
Yo, boy toy, you say you're the real champ? I say I am. Too much confusion. WrestleMania 10, Chico? Somebody gonna decide. If it takes a ladder, man, no problema. There's no rules, no ref, no time limit. Somebody, Chico, leaves WrestleMania the real champ.
Now, in yet another title matchup, Men on a Mission get their first title shot at WrestleMania 10, taking on the Quebecers. You will also see the WWF Women's Champion, Alundra Blaze, in her first title defense, taking on number one contender, Debbie Combs. What a night it's going to be. The event that was 10 years in the making is, believe it or not, just 5 weeks away, and it is going to be a classic.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Face to Face. I'm Stan Lane, sitting in for Jim Ross, and we'll be right back with more Superstars action. Don't forget, coming up on Superstars, the WWF Ladies Champion Alundra Blaze puts her title on the line against Heidi Lee Morgan. But now, let's get serious. Let's talk about the granddaddy of all pay-per-views, WrestleMania 10, Sunday, March the 20th in Madison Square Garden. Let's talk about just one of the matches at WrestleMania 10 because I am very interested in this one. The undisputed Intercontinental Champion, Razor Ramon, the bad guy, puts it all on the line against the self-proclaimed Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels. And for the first time ever at a WrestleMania, ladder rules. I caught up with Shawn Michaels earlier and I asked him, Shawn, explain the rules and strategy of a ladder match.
the rules and the strategies of a ladder match. A match that is unprecedented here in the World Wrestling Federation. And what better place for it to take place than Madison Square Garden? WrestleMania 10, the 10th anniversary. Sunday afternoon, March 20th. Well, I got news for you. This is how it goes, and I'm going to say it nice and slow and simple. The ladder is placed down the aisle. Two belts. The Undisputed Intercontinental Championship belt and Razor Ramon's bogus belt will be hoisted above the ring. The first man to beat his opponent down has to go down that aisle, bring that ladder in the ring, and climb that ladder and take down not one, but both belts. Now, that sounds pretty easy, doesn't it? I don't think so. We're talking about an 8-foot steel ladder. No rules. Razor Ramon, you're 6'6", 287 pounds. You think you're going to be quick enough to go down that aisle, grab that ladder, and climb up it? I got news for you. The slick, quick, heartbreak kid can. You're going to have to catch me, Jack. And I got news for you. You can't do it. You can't out-wrestle me. You are so baffled, so confused by the Heartbreak Kid, it is driving you crazy, and I have suckered you into one of the most dangerous matches of all time. You have fallen right into my web, and Jack, you are tangled up. Shawn Michaels is going to walk down that aisle, bring that ladder, and climb up, and show everybody he is the undisputed IC champ.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Michaels never short on confidence, but I'll tell you, take it from me, I know a ladder match is one of the most dangerous matches in the World Wrestling Federation. At Madison Square Garden, WrestleMania, we'll find out once and for all who the undisputed Intercontinental Champion is.
Welcome back to more WWF Action. Hey, how about that Lex Luger? Is he confident or what?
Man, I can't believe how confident he is. But if you want my opinion, you turn on the news at 6 o'clock, wait for the weather, and when they say there's going to be a cold day and you know where, that's his chance to winning the title from Yokozuna.
Oh, really? Mike Beraldo ready to lock up with this big monster. And it's a convoy headed to the squared circle. Look at this if you would.
Easel just towers above the crowd. Look at 6'10", 6'11", 7 foot. I don't know how big he is. He's a monster. He's bigger than Shaq.
Indeed, Diesel. And Diesel, unquestionably,
possessor of one of the most powerful right hands in the sport today.
And did you see his performance at the WWF Royal Rumble, huh? Wait a minute, let's think about Volkov. There's Nikolai Volkov.
That's a Russian spy. That's not Volkov.
You talk about all the greats in the World Wrestling Federation in the past, Nikolai Volkov. And certainly would be a pleasure to see Nikolai as part of the WrestleMania Festival and Madison Square Garden's Rotunda.
The Russian spy can't even afford a front row seat. He's in the second row. But I'll tell you, the star is just going to be at WrestleMania 10. Jenny Garth, man, she is so hot.
I know you're psyched, aren't you?
She wants me. I know she does. They all do.
Shawn Michaels on the outside, Diesel on the inside. You can bet Diesel will be on hand at WrestleMania to watch Shawn Michaels square off against Razor Ramon in the ladder match. Hey, look at this. Beraldo hammering away. Beraldo with a dropkick. Beraldo with another one.
Wow.
Beraldo trying to set up Big Diesel. Reversal. Beraldo comes off. Diesel missing. And right back.
Oh, wait a minute. You don't do that with Diesel.
Oh, my. This man is a monster.
Throw him like a rag muffin.
Yeah. Shawn Michaels in the ladder match. And Diesel is just about as tall as that 8-foot ladder. Standing by right now, ladies and gentlemen, we have pre-recorded comments from the reigning Intercontinental Champion, the Bad Guy.
Yo, boy toy. Hey, you and your big man, always together. But Chico, WrestleMania, not your big man, just you, me, and the ladder.
Wait a minute, Diesel trying to maintain it. Look at that! He deadlifts Miranda right off the canvas and chops him down!
Yes! Hey, how about that Razor Ramon, you know? My Cadillac's about a quart full of oil. Think I could get some off his hair for a refill?
Diesel now with Miranda. Oh my goodness, look at that! And the cover! And this one is history.
Yes!
Diesel, very, very tenacious. And at near 7 feet, and over that 300-pound mark. That's what it's all about, Mr. Beraldo. And that man will add insult to injury, that is for sure. And there you see.
This contest.
All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Starting out
with the man who oozes machismo. Take a look if you want. One of the great competitors in the WWF. Take a look at the gold dripping from his neck, Johnny Polo.
Yeah, thanks to that little arena urchin, the 1-2-3 child. I mean, look at Babalu Ramon. He's the Ricky Ricardo of the World Wrestling Federation. Not only is he a human toothpick holder, but a tented display model for Quaker State.
Really, the Black Phantom.
Hey, what a cool mask on the Phantom. How's he see out of that thing?
I thought maybe you were supposed to have all the answers here. I mean, but besides, what are you doing here this week?
I'm here to commentate, Vic. I am the epitome of professional wrestling journalism, and I am out here now to commentate, to spice up the show, and lend some insightful commentary and some expert analysis.
Yeah, we know. Something happens, all right. Well, what happened to WrestleMania in the ladder match? What happens with Razor Ramon? And Shawn Michaels climbed to the top of that ladder, and the two championship belts suspended above. One man will walk from WrestleMania as the undisputed champion. And by the way, later on, Shawn Michaels will be joining us in a special interview.
That's going to be good, because anytime you can get the boy toy, the heartbreak kid on television, it's just good for ratings.
And a nice takedown there by Razor Ramon, the Black Phantom. His opponent.
Black Phantom's not a bad competitor. I've seen him a time or two before. There he goes. Take it to him. Yeah, yeah.
Look at this.
Hey, told you.
And the Phantom working on the midsection of Razor Ramon. Phantom now up on the top. Look at this. And DDT's Razor Ramon.
Cover him, cover him.
And he does indeed the cover one. A sloppy cover and an easy kick out.
That was real sloppy. That was horrible.
There was. The Phantom now chopping away. Double chop to the throat area. The Phantom with Razor Ramon. Black Phantom and no. Trying to get him over the hip. Blocked again. Razor. Razor Ramon with the Black Phantom and rising down on the canvas.
Wow. They put him through the canvas right there.
Either Razor or Shawn Michaels in that ladder match could wind up out in the eighth row or something. That thing, no telling what's going to happen. I've never seen a ladder match before.
Yeah, what if you climb all the way to the top of the ladder then?
Whoa, that's what happens.
Yeah, what if you get a suplex like that off the top of the ladder? Wow.
Anything can happen at the WWF. Anything can happen at WrestleMania. And it looks like it's time for Razor Ramon to polish off the Black Phantom.
He is charismatic. I'll give him that. That guy is charismatic. He oozes it as well as grease off the back of his hair.
And the Phantom is going up. Take a look at this. The Phantom has no place to go, but this could happen from the ladder.
Oh, my.
Razor's edge.
There's no getting up from the Razor's edge.
And one, two, and this one's history.
Well, look, I got to get going, Vic. I got to get ready. The Quebecers are up next. I got to change outfits, and I'll see you in a little while.
See ya. All right. Johnny Polo is out of here. That's the best news we've had all week. Razor Ramon, victorious, ladies and gentlemen. Razor carrying the gold on his shoulder right now. The championship belt, but it's going to be hoisted above, even higher than that, Razor. Above the ladder. What a match that's going to be in approximately 3 weeks. As we head to WrestleMania, right now we're going to head to an update. Gentlemen, and yes, we are looking through a ladder, perhaps the same ladder that will go to WrestleMania in 3 weeks' time. Shawn Michaels will try and climb that ladder. So will Razor Ramon. Both men will attempt to retrieve the two championship belts that will be suspended above. One of the men will become the undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
And this is going to be exciting. Suppose, just as Razor Ramon is in that top rung of the ladder, about to reach for the belt, Shawn Michaels kicks out the ladder, and boom, down drops Razor Ramon. This is going to be exciting, Vic.
Oh, it's Vince, by the way. Anything can happen. It's a first ever for WrestleMania, a ladder match. Someone, no doubt, will climb their way all the way to the top, so to speak. All right, standing by right now, let's take you over to Ray Rougeau, about ready to interview the Heartbreak Kid.
All right, Shawn Michaels, what are the particulars in this ladder match?
First of all, Ray, I want to say we all know that a history-making event is just around the corner. WrestleMania 10, Madison Square Garden, March 20th. Now, the particulars are real simple. The rules are even simpler. There are no rules. You simply have to beat your man down, go down the aisle, retrieve the ladder, set it up, climb up to the top, and take the gold. Now, Ray, at one time, I stood here equal with a lot of people on common ground, but I wasn't happy with that. And I needed to step up and rise above everybody else. And I climbed the ladder of the World Wrestling Federation to sit on top as the man, the top dog, the big man on campus. And Shawn Michaels is gonna continue to sit on top of the World Wrestling Federation. Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 10. When everything is said and done, the Heartbreak Kid will be standing tall.
Very eloquent.
As the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. March 20th, Sunday afternoon in Madison Square Garden, the last thing you're gonna hear is, ladies and gentlemen, the Intercontinental Champion, the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time, has just left the building. The Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
That man is the epitome of confidence.
He is indeed. And look at the height. My goodness. And someone might have to actually go higher than that to get to the championship belt.
Man, this is going to be some kind of contest. You gotta tune in to WrestleMania 10 pay-per-view for this baby.
Indeed, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with more action. Stay with us.
We're gonna try to catch a word with the self-proclaimed Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels. Follow me. Shawn Michaels, can I get a word with you, please? Just a quick word.
Take it easy here. I've got nothing on. Let me put something on here. Deez, take care of this.
Hey, come on, guys. Hey, all I want is just a quick little interview, Mr. Michaels. Please, sir.
I'll be more than happy to do an interview with you, Stan the Man.
All right, thank you very much. Be right with us.
Okay, come on in, Stan. I'm ready now for you. Come on over now, buddy. Come on.
Mr. Michaels, as a result of your suspension, you were stripped of the Intercontinental belt. As you know, Razor Ramon competed in the 20-man Battle Royal and went on to defeat the model, Rick Martel, to become the undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
Yeah, what's your point? Everybody knows that Shawn Michaels makes his own rules. The only thing I'm stripped of is my clothing. And that is obvious because the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental title is still around my waist, and that is exactly where it's gonna stay.
Well, if you're the champion, then explain your actions at the Royal Rumble when you attacked Razor Ramon.
First of all, Stan, no one ever beat Shawn Michaels for the Intercontinental Championship belt. No one put his shoulders on the mat for 3 seconds. Never happened, never will. But I figured Razor Ramon ought to have a chance to see what the real, undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Championship belt looks like. So at the Royal Rumble, I gave him a bird's eye view.
You further added insult to injury when you once again interfered when Razor and the 1-2-3 Kid had a chance at winning the tag team belts from the Quebecers. Why did you feel that this was necessary?
You know, I figure any chance I can get to let Razor Ramon know that there's only one undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion, I'm going to take advantage of it. Razor Ramon, I did it, and I'm going to keep on doing it. There's only one IC champ, and you're looking at him.
As you know, Razor Ramon has been rapidly climbing the ladder of success.
Whoa, let's talk about ladders. It's Shawn Michaels who is making the supreme sacrifice by placing his undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Championship belt 20 feet above the ring in Madison Square Garden at WrestleMania, alongside that bogus belt of Razor Ramon's. When everything is said and done, it'll be the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, climbing that 8-foot ladder to success and taking what is rightfully mine, what has always been mine, the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Championship belt. And that bogus belt of Razor Ramon's, I'm going to give that to my good buddy Diesel. He's earned it.
I'm sure Razor Ramon is looking forward to settling this controversy.
I'm sick and tired of talking about Razor Ramon. I'm sick of talking to you. And don't let the door hit you on the way out. Diesel, get him out of here.
You heard him. Hit the bricks. Get out of here. Hit the bricks.
Thank you, Mr. Michaels.
Get out of here.
Hair consultant for WrestleMania 10. Yes, indeed, he is Diesel. And Diesel squaring off against Rich Myers. We'll see what Cy Sperling can do with Howard Finkel's hair in a couple of weeks. Imagine that. That's almost mission impossible. And again to the buckle. Look out!
Ooh. Oh,
Diesel a little overzealous there. Rich Myers pummeling away. Myers with a series of right hands, but Diesel
just caught his fist. Did you see that? He caught his fist. That was amazing.
Unbelievable. Diesel hammering away on Myers. Diesel, by the way, no doubt will be standing outside the ring when Shawn Michaels enters WrestleMania. The matchup, the ladder match with Razor Ramon. 8-foot ladder. Actually, Diesel's almost 7 feet in his own right.
Exactly.
Yeah, Shawn Michaels claims to be the Intercontinental Champion. Claims no one defeated him for it. That much is true. Then again, Razor Ramon unquestionably has earned the accolade of the undisputed Intercontinental Champion, but has an opportunity to put an end to all the shenanigans at WrestleMania. There will be only one recognized Intercontinental Champion after the ladder match at WrestleMania. Uh-oh! Oh my goodness!
Wow, there it was, the jackknife. Yes, the jackknife is what Diesel calls it. And what I say is, pop goes to Diesel.
Well, all I know is that Razor Ramon is in a bit of jeopardy when he heads to WrestleMania. He not only has to contend with an 8-foot ladder, he has to contend with a 7-foot Diesel on the outside and the clever Shawn Michaels on the inside. No telling what's going to happen in the ladder match, the first ever ladder match at WrestleMania.
The Intercontinental Championship also on the line as the bad guy, Razor Ramon, defends against the self-proclaimed Intercontinental Champ, Shawn Michaels. And this will be a ladder match. Now, here's how it works. Razor's Intercontinental Championship belt plus Shawn's bogus belt will be suspended high above the ring. Now, the 8-foot steel ladder starts in the aisle, and either Razor or Shawn can get it and bring it in at any time. The object is to put the ladder in the ring, climb up, and grab both belts. The superstar who does that will be declared the Intercontinental Champion. Remember, once the ladder is in the ring, it is in play. The bad guy has his sights set on the Heartbreak Kid.
WrestleMania 10, March 20th, a day where you need to strive to survive. Now, while the rest of you stand outside the fire, Shawn Michaels jumps right in. Why? Because he can take the heat. He's always done it and always will. An unprecedented match, a ladder match. Hang at the top, the IC belt. I'm going up, putting out that fire, and taking what's mine.
Yo, boy toy, the big one, only 2 weeks away. It's simple, Chico, but it's not easy. You bring your gold, I bring mine. They high above the ring, the ladder down the aisle, and at the end, the bad guy has all the gold.
Okay.
Guest ring announcer, Amy Falkenbach.
All right, Amy, go ahead. WrestleMania 10 hat on, here we go. Wait a minute, what's that ladder?
This guy is great, he's a rock star, man. Shawn Michaels is a rock star. You see that entrance? He's got the entourage, man. He's the goods.
Yeah.
Got groupies too, see her?
Oh, please, come on. Talk about rock, and that's what Little Richard's gonna do at WrestleMania. The pay-per-view spectacular. Little Richard's gonna kick it off as only the originator can. Yeah.
Look at her, she's enthralled.
She is.
She's mesmerized.
Shawn Michaels on his way to WrestleMania in a ladder match. Can you imagine that? We'll have more commentary on the ladder match with Razor Ramon when we return. Stay with us.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Icapro, you've got to want it.
Shawn Michaels and bodyguard wrestler extraordinaire Diesel getting set for individual competition, getting set for WrestleMania as well. Here we go with Shawn Michaels against Mike Moraldo. Michaels wasting no time, winding up Moraldo. Nice reversal. And another one. Drop toe, nicely done. And Shawn Michaels pretty much clowning around right now with Mike Moraldo. However, that could very well... Oh, look, as we look through the ladder, ladies and gentlemen. And Moraldo in receiving in the right hand, followed up with an elbow. I must say, the 8-foot ladder looming on the horizon here on the outside of the ring, which is where it'll be at WrestleMania. Until they haul it on the inside, the 8-foot ladder, ladies and gentlemen, is something that either Shawn Michaels or Razor Ramon will climb all the way to the top of and grasp the two championship belts hung high above. And whoever climbs that ladder and walks from the ring with the two championship belts is the undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
You look at that ladder, though, 8 foot, but I'll tell you what, it ain't but about a foot to Arden Diesel, and he's going to be on Shawn Michaels' side, and he's got his quickness. Shawn Michaels is definitely going to win the ladder match.
Uh-oh, look at this now. Diesel peering down at Moraldo. Here comes Shawn Michaels. By the way, we were told Razor Ramon is standing by, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take you back to the bad guy, the Intercontinental Champion who faces Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania. The bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Yo, boy toy. Everywhere you go, the big man's following. He carried the ladder in today. Soon, WrestleMania, maybe he can carry you out.
Someone is likely to be carried out. That is for certain. What an extraordinary matchup. That's going to be the ladder match. Imagine, if you would, though, Razor Ramon and Shawn Michaels, both of them on the top rung of the ladder, reaching up for the belts. Both men could give new meaning to the term high flyers. Oh, my goodness.
Well, that should be about it.
Would you please stop it? And one, two, and this one's history. However, I believe it'll be history for Shawn Michaels when Razor Ramon gets his hands on him at WrestleMania. What's this? They're putting a ladder in the ring.
What's he doing? What's he doing?
Hey, this isn't WrestleMania. This isn't the ladder match.
I think he's sending a little message to Babalu Ramon. He's sending a message to him.
What is this? Let's follow Shawn Michaels. Give me a break. Look at this.
I want everybody to take a look at the speed in which Shawn Michaels ran up this ladder. Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 10. This is nothing compared to what I'm going to do to you. And on March 20th at WrestleMania 10, the Heartbreak Kid is going to make history by being the first three-time World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion.
Could be. Lots more action headed your way this week, ladies and gentlemen. Bastion Booger squaring off against the Earthquake.
Face to face, I'm Stan Lane, and we are but 1 week away from the big one, WrestleMania 10, Sunday afternoon, March the 20th. You can go pick up your phone right now if you haven't done so already. I know you have, but in case you hadn't, go do it right now. Call your local cable companies to join us exclusively on pay-per-view. And speaking of picking up that phone, do it right now, too, because the WrestleMania 10 hotline is open. The lines are open, and they are hot, hence the term hotline. So you can call me, because I'll give you behind-the-scenes action during WrestleMania 10. Or you can call before that, like right now, for instance, and you can hear all kinds of superstars talking about what's going to be happening at WrestleMania 10. You can play WrestleMania trivia. You can also talk to a mystery guest. We don't know who it's going to be yet, but each and every day, a new mystery guest will tell about his favorite memory of the past WrestleMania. It's going to be unbelievable. The lines are open now, the WrestleMania hotline, so pick up your phone and call. Now let's talk about one of the matches signed to WrestleMania 10. Ladder rules, the bad guy, the undisputed Intercontinental Champion Razor Ramon, will face Shawn Michaels. Earlier, I talked to Shawn and asked him, if you are victorious at WrestleMania 10, what do you plan to do with Razor's belt?
Oh, well, let me get this right. If Shawn Michaels is victorious, or when he's victorious at WrestleMania 10, it's still Razor's belt, huh? You know something? You guys and everybody in the World Wrestling Federation cannot stand the fact that the Heartbreak Kid is and always will be the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion. You can call it Razor's belt. You can call it anybody's belt. But I know, Big Daddy Cool knows, Razor Ramon knows, and all the
the fans of the World Wrestling Federation know that there is only one man. That is the undisputed World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion, and it is the Heartbreak Kid himself, Shawn Michaels. Like it.
Boy, is that Shawn Michaels confident or what? I talked to the bad guy earlier, too, and I asked him, if you win this ladder match, what do you intend to do with Shawn's belt?
First of all, Chico, when I win this ladder match at WrestleMania 10 in front of the whole world, what am I going to do with Shawn's belt? I don't know. Maybe I throw it out into the crowd, huh? MSG, they go crazy. Maybe I melt it down, some new chains. Maybe I wear one on the front, one on the back. Maybe I sell it, buy me a new Cadillac. But one thing is for sure. There can only be one champ, and it's me.
Don't forget, fans, 1 week away. That's right, next Sunday, March the 20th, WrestleMania 10. Go pick up your phone right now and call your local cable company to join us exclusively on Pay-Per-View.
You know, Tatanka seems focused. He seems ready, but I tell you, Yokozuna has an awful high mountain to climb.
Well, we're taking a look at the bad guy, Razor Ramon. You know something I'm thinking about it, Stan? Tatanka, when he got squashed by Yokozuna and put on the shelf, there was just a little something missing when he came back. But now he's got those eagle feathers. That may be the difference.
Yeah, well, the bad guy's got his goal back, and that has made him complete. Once again, he is oozing machismo, Gorilla.
Boy, he certainly is. Everyone here, all the superstars, well, with the exception of maybe one in the World Wrestling Federation, have tremendous respect for the bad guy, Razor Ramon. Let's face it, he had to climb a high mountain, just like he's going to have to climb a high ladder, Stan, if he wants to remain the Intercontinental Champion.
Oh, you got that right. We're talking ladder match rules at WrestleMania 10, Gorilla. Both Intercontinental belts, the undisputed belt of Razor Ramon and the bogus belt of Shawn Michaels, will be hanging from the ceiling as Razor Ramon gives this kid some instructions. You know what they'll have to do? They'll have to go down the aisle and grab an 8-foot steel ladder, bring it back into the ring, climb the ladder, and grab both belts to be the undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
Well, one thing is for sure, Stan, that when the smoke all clears at Madison Square Garden next Sunday afternoon, we will indeed have one undisputed Intercontinental Champion.
Well, you got that right. You know, speaking of smoke, the smoke that I'm concerned about is that diesel smoke from that big 7-foot-tall 18-wheeler bodyguard Diesel.
Well, that Diesel is almost as tall as the ladder, Stan.
You got that right.
Give me a break.
And he's dangerous, too.
Look at the awesome power here, upper body strength of Razor Ramon. That's going to be maybe the deciding factor in this match.
Well, he's looking good, and he always keeps himself in tremendous shape. The bad guy does.
Don't underestimate the style, the superiority, the fantastic ability of the boy toy, Shawn Michaels, claiming to be the wrestler of the 90s. He may well be.
And we cannot forget about that superlative performance on Monday Night Raw, the 20-man Battle Royal. Oh, my goodness. And then a week later, Gorilla, he defeated the model Rick Martel to become the Intercontinental Champion.
Well, you have to fill some very big shoes if you want to be the Intercontinental Champion. Look at that. Beautiful fireman's carry takeover. Holds on to the arm. You know, some great guys have held that title. Talk about Bret the Hitman Hart, Macho Man Randy Savage, and if you even want to say, Shawn Michaels.
Well, you know, Shawn Michaels still insists. He says, no one ever beat me for this title. But hey, we all know that's the bogus belt.
Well, it certainly is. He was stripped of that title by WWF President Jack Tunney, and now both of those belts next Sunday afternoon will be suspended high above Madison Square Garden from the rafters, and the first guy able to get his opponent in a compromised position can climb the ladder and retrieve the gold.
Shawn Michaels will never relinquish that belt until WrestleMania 10, when we watch Razor Ramon climb that ladder and grab both belts.
A little offense here unloaded on Razor, but whoa, he just about had enough. A beautiful knife edge finds the mark. And another shot right in the kisser. A Beal out of the corner. Holy mackerel.
Wow.
How on earth is Shawn Michaels Stan Lane going to deal with the tremendous upper body power of Razor Ramon?
Well, maybe he won't. Maybe that's why he's going to have Diesel probably watching from the wings.
Slaps it on. Oh, tremendous pressure being applied here.
I could hear Tony DeVito screaming, but apparently he's not submitting. Well, this looks painful. I think Razor Ramon is sending a message right now to Shawn Michaels.
You know, we haven't talked at all, Stan, about how dangerous this ladder match is. Can you imagine being perched up on the top, thinking you've got everything in control, and all of a sudden the ladder goes toppling down because your opponent has tipped it over? It could be a career-ending match.
Well, think about this, Shawn Michaels, Mr. Boy Toy. Imagine if Shawn Michaels got Razor's edge from the top of that 8-foot steel ladder.
Oh, another first for WrestleMania 10. So many innovations in this blockbuster. You won't want to miss one split second of it.
Razor Ramon is toying with Tony DeVito like a cat toys with a mouse.
Oh, look at this. Perched up now on the top turnbuckle.
This could be the big one coming up here, Gorilla.
Razor, second turnbuckle on the inside.
Super
suplex.
Wow.
I believe he's reached the end of his rope.
He's got that look. Oh, yeah.
That's it. We are indeed going to see a Razor's Edge.
This place just erupted. They know what that look means.
This march to WrestleMania would not be complete without a Razor's Edge. And here it comes.
They want it. And here it comes.
Once you reach that point, it's too late.
It's a done deal.
It's curtain time.
It's all about the crying.
Ooh, wow.
Oh, my.
Take a good look, Sean. This is what'll be facing you next Sunday afternoon at Madison Square Garden.
Woo, I can't wait, Gorilla. 4 o'clock Eastern and 1 o'clock Pacific, WrestleMania 10, 10 years in the making.
And by far the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time, the Big Apple will be rocking next Sunday afternoon when WrestleMania 10 invades Madison Square Garden. You won't want to miss it. Let's take you back now to our colleague, Vince McMahon.
All right, thank you, Gorilla Monsoon. What a matchup that was with Razor Ramon standing.
Look at all these bikes, man. This is great. Johnny Polo is in his element. There's lots of money. Harley Davidson's. But I'll tell you what, Vic, if you're going to ride a bike, got to turn the head around backwards, because otherwise it'll blow right off.
I'll tell you who'd like to ride, and that's Rhonda Shearer. She'd like to have Razor Ramon on the back of her Wide Glide coming right down 6th Avenue.
Well, wait, I'd like to get in that thing, but get rid of Razor Ramon and put me in a sidecar.
I can tell you this. Some of these Harley Davidsons are a little on the dangerous side if you happen to have an accident.
Yeah, you could have quite a spill, but how about the ladder match? Imagine if you took a spill off that 8-foot ladder. That'd be like coming off this catwalk with all them Harley Davidsons landing right on top of your head.
Shawn Michaels, Razor Ramon, one of them will emerge from Madison Square Garden as the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. Here to tell you all about the matchup. Now let's take you to Todd Pettengill.
Thanks, guys. Todd.
Everybody listen to me. For too long, been two champions, two belts. This Sunday, WrestleMania 10, the ladder match. The bad guy takes all the gold.
Well, one thing is definitely for certain. After WrestleMania 10, there will only be one Intercontinental Champion in the World Wrestling Federation. Right now, let's get back to the Harley-Davidson Cafe here on WWF Superstars, Vince McMahon and Johnny Polo.
What a WrestleMania. What a ladder match. A first ever for a WrestleMania. Imagine the two championship belts suspended above the ring. Shawn Michaels and... Hey, what do you think you're doing? Shawn Michaels, ladies and gentlemen, and Razor Ramon, each one wants to be the undisputed Intercontinental Champion. Now, in this matchup, as far as rules are concerned, well, there almost aren't any rules. I mean, there's no time limit. There's no disqualification. You can actually use the ring ladder almost like a game of ring ropes.
There is no nothing. There are no rules. That's the unique thing about it. But I'll tell you what, you know what the real advantage is? Diesel. Diesel's going to be on the side of Shawn Michaels. Who does Razor Ramon have? Nobody, because nobody likes the bad guy.
I'll tell you this. This is going to be one of the most exciting Intercontinental Championship matches, perhaps, of all time. Hey, I got an idea. How about we crank up our soft tails and head on over to Times Square?